Hi, I'm here at Bowerman's Nose on Dartmoor tonight. It's looking pretty impressive at the moment. There's a beautiful sunset. I'm going to shoot two clips tonight, one star trail later on, and I'm doing the sunset at the moment. I'm going to join these two together. It's Bowermans Nose. It's about 4 miles northeast of Widdicombe on the Moor. And legend has it that Bowerman was a hunter. Witches, and they were so angry that they turned him to stone, and there he stands. He's about 6 meters tall, and Hound Tor is a couple of miles in that direction, and that's where his hounds were turned to stone. So I'm here just 2 days after the summer solstice, and because the sun sets so far to the north, as far as it can reach, which is at 309 degrees, I'm able to get the setting sun over to the left of the frame, about there like that, and the Polaris, the pole star, hopefully just above the rock stack there, later on comes out. So there's my camera shooting away. It's with a 10mm lens on a crop sensor camera, so that's the equivalent of about a 16mm lens on a full frame camera, and should be quite an impressive little thing with the sunset going on one side and hopefully able to blend it into a star trail on the other side. I'm using an ND filter, an ND32, which is slowing down my shots to 2 seconds. I'm using a Myops Smart Plus connected to the top of my camera, which is in HDR time-lapse mode at the moment, and it's taking 3 shots every 20 seconds. The one in the middle is 2 seconds, and then a shot each side of that, which is bracketed 2 stops each side of that. So I can have a fiddle around with them and see which of the three looks best in Photoshop later on. Fantastic night. There's a few lovely little wispy clouds, nothing much. I'm shooting 240 frames like that, so that's going to give me an 8 second clip, and it's going to take me 80 minutes. Sunset was at 9:30 this evening, and I started at 8:40, which was the beginning of golden hour. And that's going to take me through till 10 o'clock, and then I'm going to do my ramping experiment, which is something I've not tried before, using the Myops Smart Plus again. You can put it in bulb ramping time-lapse mode, and I'll explain a bit more about that later when the time comes. Okay, the sun's gone down, it's 10 o'clock, and I'm on to the next stage now. I've put the Myops Smart Plus into bulb ramping mode, and basically what it does is I've set the camera with the settings that I want to do the star trail with, which is f4, 1600 ISO. So I've begun with a short exposure, just 1/10 of a second in with such sensitive settings, ISO 1600 f4. And then the last exposure, 2 hours later, is going to be a lot longer, 1 minute 19 seconds, which is what I'm going to be shooting the stars with. So gradually over that 2 hours, the exposures are going to get longer and longer and merge daylight into night. So it's only going to give me a 3 second clip. But that's fine, because it's only going to be used as a little transition between the sunset time-lapse, which I made, and the star trail time-lapse. It's just going to give a smooth transition from day to night, hopefully. I've got a little moon up there. I didn't know. Setting at the moment. So it's going to be set down behind the horizon at midnight when the star trail begins, and we'll see how it goes. So there we are. Okay, so I've finished the ramping. exposure time lapse, using the MyOp Smart Plus again for long exposure this time. It's a much simpler program, but they're all the same length each exposure. I'm setting them to 1 minute 19 seconds with a second interval between each exposure. So doing that for 3 hours, it's not going to be a very long clip, only about 4.5 seconds, but I've got the sunset bit as well, which I did, so I can join them together and make an interesting little video. It's going to be part of the upcoming dramatic Dartmoor video, which is just a compilation of time-lapse clips from all over Dartmoor, different times of day and night, different weathers, different times of year, all shot by me over the last year or so. Got a few nice ones in the bag already. I've still got quite a lot to do, so it's an exciting time. Can't wait to see it when it's done. Should be out sometime next year, hopefully. Thanks for watching.